Okay, everyone. Let's start with our accountancy part. So we were basically discussing accounting equation in accounts. So in the previous class, I think we have solved a few questions based on accounting equation. Right, Samiksha and Mazin?
Yes.
Okay. Yes.
All right. So just revise everything and then we will start doing a few more questions based on accounting equation. So till now we have understood the meaning of accounting equation. I have told that accounting equation is basically a mathematical expression that shows the assets and liabilities of a firm are equal. And on the basis of accounting, one will be easily able to identify the effect of business transaction upon the value of assets and liability. And we have also covered that that total asset of the business is always equal to total claims, and total claims include liability plus capital. And in order to calculate the value of liability, we can simply differentiate the value of assets minus capital, and for capital we can calculate assets minus liability. All right. And after that we have done few business transaction and understood how it will impact the various items of the business. After that we have done few questions based on the accounting equation, and I have also given you few homeworks. All right, so in today's session we will be doing few more questions based on the same concept, and I'll be teaching you few new concepts as well in this class. And after that, let's see. Okay, so basically let's start with question number 5. I have given this question as a homework to you.
Yes sir, this was homework.
That was in homework. All right.
Yes.
Okay. So I will have to basically write the question. Okay, so note down the question. First of all, prepare an accounting equation. Prepare accounting equation, and information business transactions are given. Number one, Ajit has started business with cash rupees 20,000. All right. And then he purchased furnitures. He purchased furnitures costing rupees 2,000. He also paid rent. He paid rent of rupees 200. Fourth transaction is that he purchased goods on credit. He purchased goods on credit rupees 3,000. And last transaction is he sold goods. Cost price of those goods were 2,000, but it was sold by him for rupees 5,000 on cash. On 5,000 on cash. So this is the question. Basically, first of all, Ajit has started a business with rupees 20,000 cash. Then he purchased furniture. He paid rent. He purchased goods on credit. He sold goods for rupees 5,000 on cash. Tell me once you are done. We'll be solving this question.
Done, sir.
Everyone?
Yes, sir.
Okay. All right. Very good. Now, what do we do? Now, we will make a statement starting with serial number. All right. And the transactions. And after this, we will prepare a column for assets and then for the liability. And in this column, we will also write liability and capital as well. All right. Okay. So Halima has just joined us. Halima, we are basically solving this question. I have given the question to the student. These are five business transactions and we have to prepare basically an accounting equation. Sorry?
The one from the homework or new?
No. I have written this question now. So this is a question I have just given to the students. So these are the five business transactions and we have to record these business transactions on the basically on this statement, preparing an accounting equation. So first of all, first transaction is, what is the transaction? Ajit started business with cash. So we will write started business. How will it affect the business? So it will basically add the cash.
Add cash and add capital.
Add capital. All right. So we will write 20,000 under the heading of cash and 20,000 under the heading of capital. All right. Let me zoom out a little. It is not zoomed. Okay. After this, we have purchased furnitures. Furniture purchased. So nothing is mentioned. So we will assume that furniture has been purchased on cash. All right. So furniture purchase will reduce the value of cash, but it will increase the furniture. All right. So we will add 2000 here and reduce 2000 from the cash. After this, we will basically calculate the total value and make a new equation. So now the total value of cash will stand at 18,000. Plus this is 2000 and here it is 20,000. Both the sides must tally. Liability plus capital equals to assets. So both the sides are tallied. Now the third transaction is, what is the third transaction? Third is he paid rent of rupees 200. So rent is what? Rent is a
expense.
Rent, correct. Rent paid. Rent is an expense. So when we will pay rent, it will reduce
cash and decrease from capital.
Correct. Reduces cash as well as capital. Now we will prepare new equation. New equation will be. What will be the new equation? 17,800 plus 2,000. And here we have 19,800. All right. Moving on to the fourth transaction, purchase goods on credit. When we purchases goods on credit, all right, what will happen? So when we will purchase goods on credit, first of all, goods will increase. There will be increase in goods worth rupees 3,000. All right, because we have purchased goods on credit, so we will have creditor under the heading of liability. Creditor. There will be creditor of rupees 3,000. So we will add 3,000 under the liability. Okay. After this, we will make a new equation again. What will be the new equation this time? So new equation will be 17,800 plus 2,000 plus 3,000 plus 3,000 and plus 19,800. All right, everyone.
Yes, sir.
Now, next is last item, fifth item is he sold goods on goods costing rupees 2,000 for rupees 5,000. So basically, Ajit have sold goods of rupees 2,000 at 5,000. So basically, in this case,
so he's cash having will increase 5,000 and subtract 2,000 from goods and add 3,000 to capital.
Perfect. So goods will reduce by 2,000. All right. Cash will increase by 3,000 and capital and will 5, also
5,000. Sir, add cash 5,000.
Why cash will be added at 5,000?
Because
achha, okay, 5,000.
And capital plus
capital will be increases by 3,000. All right, so this will be the new equation. All right, so ye ho jayega. This will be
22,800
plus 2,000 plus we have 1,000 and this is 3,000 plus 22,800. This will be the final equation. So this is the answer. Okay. So I think everybody is capable of doing this kind of question now. Now we will move further and we will learn a few more concepts in this chapter. Okay. See, there are a few special transactions in this chapter as well. There are four special transactions in this chapter. First is paid or received in full settlement. Second kind of a special transaction is outstanding expenses, that is salary, rent or wages, etc. And there is advance payment and receipt kind of business transaction. And there is one more business transaction, which is called business transaction relating to accrued items, accrued incomes, incomes which is due but not paid. All right. So there are basically all transactions, we have four kind of special transactions. So let's discuss all of these transactions one by one. First of all, we will be discussing payment and receipt in full settlement. Okay, so what do you mean by the payment in full settlement? Basically, let's say suppose I have borrowed certain amount from Sameeksha. All right. Let's say I have borrowed, 5,000 from Sameeksha. And after some time, Sameeksha is asking for money. And I have asked her to accept 4,000 instead of 5,000. I am only paying her 4,000 instead of 5,000. And she is ready to accept that amount. So this acceptance is considered as full settlement against 5,000. All right. So basically, she requires to receive 5,000 from me, but what I am doing, I am only paying her 4,000 instead of paying 5,000. So this will be known as payment in full settlement, or from the Sameeksha's point of view, this is called receipt in full settlement. Instead of receiving 5,000, she has received only 4,000, and she has basically release the liability of the other person, saying that, okay, I'm ready to accept 4,000 instead of 5,000. This is called receipt in full settlement. And from my point of view, this is known as payment in full settlement. All right, everyone. So let's do few questions based on this. Let's take this example. See, prepare the accounting equation from the following transactions below. First of all, what is happening? First business transaction is Ramesh has started business with cash rupees 50,000 and goods rupees 20,000. And after this, purchase goods from Suresh rupees 25,000. We have purchased goods rupees 25,000 from Suresh. So because here name is mentioned, so we will presume that we have bought goods on cash or on credit. What we will presume if the name is mentioned, what credit. We will presume that we have bought good from Suresh on credit. All right. Okay. Next point is payment to creditor rupees 20,000 made in full settlement. So Suresh is our creditor. All right, because we are purchasing goods from Suresh on credit, so Suresh is a creditor. What we are doing now, we are paying 20,000 in full settlement to the creditor. What is the total amount due against against Suresh?
25,000
is the total amount due. So total amount of creditor is 25,000, but instead of paying 25,000, we are only paying 20,000 and making the full settlement. We are clearing the account. We are saying that, sir, I can only pay 20,000 instead of 25,000. And he is also releasing his liability from us. So this is called full settlement. Okay, next transaction is sold goods for rupees 30,000 to Mahesh. Now we have sold goods to Mahesh for rupees 30,000, because here also name is mentioned. We will presume that we have sold goods to Mahesh on credit. All right. Now received rupees 20,000 from debtor in full settlement. Because we have sold good to Mahesh on credit, Mahesh will be treated as debtor for the business. And we as a debtor, he needs to pay 30,000, but he is only paying how much? He is only paying 20,000, and we are accepting such amount as a full settlement. We are clearing his account. We are basically saying that, okay, no problem. You pay us 22,000 and you will be released from all of your liability. All right. So sold goods for rupees 30,000 to Mahesh. Mahesh is a debtor and we are receiving only 20,000 from the debtor. So we have to basically make the accounting equation based on this transaction. So all of you start doing, and along with you guys also, I'll be also doing this question. And at the end, we will tell your answers. So no need to note the question. I'll share the updated PowerPoint. You will get these questions. All you need to do is solve the question.
Sir,
yeah,
is the cash 5 lakh or 50,000?
Just a minute. Cash is 5 lakh. No, all right, keep it as 5 lakh. It should be, actually it should be 50,000, but I have written,
yes, sir,
here.
Yes, that's why I
wrote. Let me change it to 50,000.
Sir, and down 20,000.
Sir, goods also 20,000.
Goods.
Yeah, goods are also 20,000. Just a minute.
Sir,
yeah,
this is the question we have to do the answer for, right?
Yeah.
Okay, sir.
So the question, first business transaction is started business. Started business. Okay, see, the first transaction, Ramesh is basically starting business with cash as well as good. All right, so basically he is bringing capital in cash as well as good. So how will it affect the equation? It will basically add cash
plus
as goods. An asset plus goods.
Plus goods. That plus will be capital.
And, okay. So it will be basically 50,000 in cash, 20,000 as goods.
70,000.
And what will be the amount of capital?
70,000.
Correct. Capital will be 70,000 because he is bringing in capital in the form of cash as well as in good. All right. Now, the second transaction. Second is Ramesh has started, purchased goods from Suresh for ₹25,000. So because we have purchased goods from Suresh on credit, so Suresh will be treated as our creditor. So there will be creditor added under the heading of liability. Purchase goods. Second transaction is purchased goods. So because we have purchased goods of 25,000, value of goods will be increased by 25,000, and we have purchased those goods on credit. So there, the value of liability will also increase by 25,000. So new equation will look something like this: 50,000 plus 45,000. And here we have 25,000 plus 70,000. Okay. Moving on to the third business transaction. Third transaction is payment to creditor ₹20,000 in full settlement. See, basically, what is the total amount due on Suresh? What is the total amount due again? Basically on us? Is 25,000, right? And we are making payment of rupees only 20,000. So what is the amount of profit that we have?
5,000.
So how will it affect the accounting equation? First of all, cash will be reduced by 20,000.
Yes.
But creditor will be reduced by 25,000. And what will be the remaining amount?
And 5,000 will add to capital.
Perfect.
Add to capital.
Very good. So we will write it as paid to creditors in full settlement. In full settlement. So it will reduce 20,000 in cash. It will reduce 25,000 in the liability, in the creditor, and 5,000 will be added to the capital. 5,000 will be added to the credit capital. So now new equation will be 30,000 plus 45,000. And this is 0 plus 75,000. Fourth transaction. Fourth transaction is sold goods rupees. Sold goods to Mahesh. Obviously, because name is mentioned, so we will presume that Mahesh is our debtor. Goods will be sold to debtor on credit. So debtor will be added. We have sold goods to debtor for ₹30,000. So 30,000 will be added to debtor, and goods will be reduced by 30,000. Okay, new equation will look something like this: 30,000 plus 15,000 plus 30,000, then 0 plus 75,000. Last transaction, fifth, received amount in full settlement. Received in full settlement. So what is the total amount that we have received in full settlement? We have received 22,000 against 30,000. So basically we are having loss or profit this time?
Loss of
8,000. So how will it affect the accounting equation? It will reduce the cash, right?
Capital.
It will reduce it will the
add,
cash?
No, add the add to the capital, it reduce will add the debtor to 0 and minus 8,000 to capital.
Correct. So basically, just 22,000 we are receiving, so we will add this to cash, and 30,000 will be reduced because we are accepting the debtor in full settlement, and because we are having loss of 8,000, so we will reduce the capital by 8,000. So this will be our final equation. This will be our final equation. Final equation will look like 52,000 plus 15,000 plus 0, then 0 plus how much it will be? 67,000. All right, everyone. So you must ensure that both the sides should tally. 67,000 and 67,000 must be the total value.
Yes.
Yes, sir.
Halima, Peer, Samiksha.
Yes, everyone. Sir.
Yes.
Okay. Halima, are you clear? Halima, is there any doubt?
Last part.
You have doubt.
Can you explain again? Last part.
Yeah. So basically, the last transaction. Just a minute. See, in the last transaction, what we have done, we have basically information is that received rupees 22,000 from debtor in full settlement. So what is the total amount of debtor? Total amount of debtor is 30,000. And we basically, we have a right to receive 30,000, but we are accepting 22,000 against 30,000. So basically, we will, just a minute. We have received 20,000 as cash. So we will add the value of cash by 22,000. But because we have received this amount in full settlement against the debtor, so we will reduce the entire amount of debt. We have reduced 30,000 of debtor. And now, because we are having loss here, 30,000 against 30,000, we have only received 22,000. So we have a loss of around 8,000. So we have reduced this loss from the amount of capital. All right, Halima. This I have already told you that whenever there is an expense or there is a loss, we will reduce the value of capital. All right. So now new equation will be 30,000 plus 22,000 equals to 52,000 plus 15,000. Then 30,000 minus 30,000 will be zero. And here we have only 67,000 after reducing 8,000 from 75,000. Halima, is it clear now?
Yes, sir. It's clear.
Okay. Next. So from the special transaction, we have already covered the first kind of a special transaction, paid any amount in full settlement or received any amount in full settlement. Now, this second kind of transaction is outstanding expense. Outstanding expense. Like salary or what is outstanding expense? Outstanding expense basically means expense which is due on us, but we are not paying it. Like suppose we have hired an employee and his salary is due. His salary is due for the last 3 months, but we are not clearing his salary. We are not paying his salary. So because we are not paying his salary, it is a kind of liability upon us. Is it clear? So any kind of outstanding expense is a liability. Okay. So we will learn how to treat such kind of business transaction. See, example based on outstanding expense. This is the example. Prepare the accounting equation from the following transaction given below. Number one is started business with cash of rupees 10,000. Then we have paid salary of 4,500 and salary outstanding is being 1,000. Can you tell me what was the total amount of salary? What would have been the total amount of salary? Paid salary 4,500 and still salary outstanding is 1,000. So what was the total amount of salary?
5,500.
All right. Okay. Now, so out of the 5,500, we have only paid 4,500. So it will reduce the cash by 4,500. All right. It will basically reduce the capital by 4,500 as well, because it is a kind of expense. Okay. And 1,000 is outstanding. So it will create liability upon business with the name of outstanding salary. After that, the third transaction is interest due but not paid. Suppose there is some interest needed to be paid by the business, but business is not clearing that interest. So interest is also due and business not cleared such interest. So interest due but not paid is also a kind of liability. interest outstanding. Okay, wages outstanding 2000, wages has not also hasn't been paid by the business. So how we will treat these transaction, let's learn. See, as usual, first of all, we will be making statement for accounting equation. Like we will write serial number, the transactions, and assets, then liability plus capital. Okay, so first transaction is started business with cash. Started business. Started with business with cash. So we will write cash here. 10,000 is the amount of investment which was made at the beginning of the business. Started business with cash of rupees 10,000. So it will add the value of cash under the assets, and it will also increases capital by 10,000. Okay. After this, the second transaction is paid salary of rupees 4,500 and salary outstanding is being 1,000. Pay attention here. So second transaction is salary paid. How much salary is paid? Only 4,500 has been paid. But the total expense, total obligation was 5,500. So what we will do, see, salary paid. By we will reduce the cash by 4,500, but because total liability was, total obligation to pay the expense was 5,500, so it will basically reduce the amount of capital by 5,500. Is it clear, everyone? Because salary has been paid only 4,500, but the total amount of expense was actually 5,500, so we will reduce the capital by 5,500. And also, because 1,000 is due, so we will write it as outstanding salary. Outstanding salary. How much salary is due?
1,000.
Outstanding salary by 1,000. Try the other transactions. Is the second transaction clear to everyone?
Yes, sir.
See, second transaction, what we have done in the second transaction, we have, because we have paid only 4,500 as salary, but the total amount of expense that was due was 5,500. So we have reduced the capital by 5,500 and we have reduced the cash by 4,500. And because salary outstanding is, salary is still outstanding, so we have increases the liability by 1,000. All right, so we will now make a new equation, and it will look like 10,000 minus 4,500 will be 5,500. Okay, and this is 1,000, and here we have 4,500. Okay, so both the sides tally, 5,500 and 5,500. Now the third transaction is interest due but not paid. Interest due, not paid. What will happen? Tell me, what will happen? Interest due but not paid.
Reduce from capital and add it to interest liability.
Capital will reduce by 1,000. Okay, so 1,000
to liability. 1,000
of capital will be reduced, and we will write interest outstanding as the liability, interest outstanding. I don't have the space, so I'm not writing it very clearly. So if you are having a space, you can write it as interest outstanding. All right. So here we have nothing added. So new equation will be plus, this is 1000 and this is, new equation will be 5500. And here we have 1000 as outstanding salary, 1000 as interest outstanding, and remaining is basically capital. Capital, we will have only 3500. Now, the fourth transaction is wages outstanding. Okay, wages outstanding is 2000. So we will write wages outstanding. So outstanding wages, we will add one more point here, outstanding wages. Okay, and right here, wages outstanding will reduce the capital by 2000, all right? Right? And it will increases the outstanding wages by 2000. So we will write here as 2000 plus 2000. So what will be the balancing figure? We will have 5500 here as cash, 1000 as outstanding salary, 1000 as interest outstanding, and 1500 as capital, and 2000 as outstanding wages. So this is your final equation. This is your final equation. Anyone having doubt? Anyone having problem? Halima, Mazen, Peer?
No, sir.
Halima, is everything clear? Samiksha, everything clear?
Yes, sir, clear.
Okay. So we have covered two kind of special transactions. First was regarding the receipt and payment in full settlement. And the second was basically regarding the outstanding expenses, how we will treat the outstanding expenses. All right. Now, the third kind of special transaction. Third kind of a special transaction is basically advance payment and receipts. What happens sometimes, we make payment in advance. All right. And there are certain situations when we receive payment in advance. So always remember that whenever you make payment in advance, it will be treated as an asset for you. All right. Suppose if you have paid some amount in advance, suppose you have if you have a prepaid internet connection. All right. So amount that you have already paid for your internet connection will be treated as the asset for you. Similarly, the amount that you have received in advance from some party will be treated as a liability for you. All right. So advance payment and receipt, how advance payment and receipt will affect the accounting equation, we will be now discussing this. So in order to cover this concept, we have the other question. We have one more question. Prepare the accounting equation from the following transaction given below. And the question is basically started business with cash of rupees 40,000. And we have the second transaction paid salary in advance of rupees 5,000, paid insurance 1,000, and commission received and in advance 6,000. So you guys start doing it. I will show you the solution once I'm done. And please tell me the answer once you are done. All right, everyone.
Yes, sir.
Halima, Mazen, Peer, start doing this question. Try, at least try, then I will solve it for you.
Okay, sir.
Sir, commission comes under cash, right?
Commission received, yeah. Commission is basically cash.
Oh, okay.
Sir, for insurance, you should open another one in assets.
Correct. Prepaid insurance is an asset. Okay. Just like prepaid salary is an asset. You have to open different column for asset, different heading for asset.
So the second transaction, paid salary in advance, it will be an asset or liability?
See, because you are making advance payment, it will not be treated as a liability, number one, because you have made the advance payment, it will always be treated as a as an asset. So what will happen in this case, it will reduces cash by 5,000 and it will increases asset in the form of advance salary under the heading of asset. We will create one more asset, which is known as advance salary. And it will increases by 5,000. Getting my point? Basically, cash will be reduced, advance salary will be increased. Is that clear?
Yeah.
Okay.
Same thing have to do with the insurance, right?
All
right.
Same thing will be done with the insurance. We will write.
Sir, I got the answer.
Okay. Samisha, what is the answer?
Sir, okay,
wait for a minute. Wait for a minute. Let me also calculate. I'm not done with the solution. Just a minute.
Sir, so 5,000 will not be reduced in capital.
No, capital will not be affected in any manner, because advance payment is not an expense. Advance, if you are making an advance payment, it will not be treated as as basically the expense. Expense only reduces the capital. Advance payment is not treated as an expense, because in case of advance payment, we are yet to receive the benefit. All right. Only when you have received the benefit and you are making payment against that, it will be treated as an expense. But if you are yet to receive the benefit and you have made the payment in advance, it will be treated as the prepaid expense. It will not be basically treated as an expense.
Okay, sir.
All right. In case of commission received, what will be done? In case
sir,
of commission,
add it to cash and then it will be liability.
Correct. So cash will be added by 6,000 and it will create a form of liability upon us, which is called prepaid commission. commission received in advance. Advance commission.
Sir,
final equation answer? Is?
Sir, finish.
Okay, tell me the final answer. Samisha, you.
Sir, assets is 46,000 when you add.
Okay, and correct.
Liabilities plus capital 46,000. 40,000 plus 6,000.
Okay, all right. So, what is the amount of cash?
40,000.
And advance salary?
6,000.
All right. See, if anyone is not able to complete this question, see, this is the solution. Let me explain this. First of all, what is given in the question? Mr. Basically, the person is starting businesses with rupees 40,000. So we have added cash here and the capital by 40,000. Now there is paid payment of salary in advance. So what we have done, because we have made the payment, we have reduced the cash by 5,000. But because it is an advance payment, so we have basically created an asset called advance salary. All right. And we have increases the value of that advance salary by 5,000. There will be no change in the liability, no change in the capital. Okay. Moving on, we have prepared a new equation. 40,000 minus 5,000, it will be 35,000, then plus 5,000. And here we have 40,000. So 40,000 and 35 plus 50. This is also 40,000. So both the sides are basically tally. Now, third business transaction is prepaid insurance. Because we have made the paid the insurance, so we have reduced 1,000 here. But insurance is because we have paid the insurance in advance, so we will create one more asset under the heading of asset. It will be known as prepaid insurance. And we will increase this insurance by 1,000, increase this asset by 1,000. And there will be no change in capital as well as in the liability. So the new equation will stand at 34,000 plus 5,000 plus 1,000 equals to 40,000. Now, last business transaction is commission received. Because we are receiving this time and this is an advance amount. So it will increase the value of cash, but it will also be liability at the same time. So we have created a liability under the heading of liability as advance commission received. And we have increases it by 6,000. So now we will calculate the total value of asset and liability. So total value of asset will be cash 40,000, advance salary will be 5,000, prepaid insurance will be 1,000, and advance commission received is 6,000 plus this is 40,000. So both the sides are tallying with 46,000 each. Is it clear, everybody?
Yeah. Yes, sir.
So, Steve's
Sir, I want to ask that if commission is not advance, will it have any difference?
Okay, Halima, if commission is not in advance, it will be treated as an expense. All right. So, what will happen if you have received commission? All right. So, it will increases the value of cash first of all, and because you have received it is a kind of revenue for you. So it will be added here in the capital. Getting my point? If you will receive commission, yes, sir, not in advance, if you have received commission and nothing is mentioned, so basically commission will increase the value of cash as well as the value of capital. But if you have received the commission as advance, it will increases the cash as well as it will increases the value of liability. So value of liability will be increased by 6,000 as well. Is that clear, Halima?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Is it only for commission or other things also?
In case of every advance receipts, this is basically example I have taken. But if you receive anything in advance, let's say if you have received rent in advance, if you have any kind of income that you have received in advance. Let's suppose I have received fees in advance, for example. So fees in advance will be treated as a liability for me. It will increases my cash as well as it will be considered as a liability for me. All right. But what about if I have already rendered you classes, if I have already taught you everything and after that you are paying my fees. So in that case, fees is not received in advance. Fees is I'm receiving fees after paying my services. So in that case, fees received will increase the value of cash, as well as it will increase the value of. Tell me.
Capital.
Halima, is it clear, Halima? Do you still have doubt? Okay, perfect. So Mazen, Peer Muhammad, Samiksha, Steve, is there any doubt? Do you want to ask anything from today's session?
No, sir.
I think this is it for today. I'll be sharing you so many questions based on these concepts that we have covered in basically two classes, today and in the previous one. So please do all of those questions. And if you face any difficulty in any question, please do let me know in the next class. So I'll be sharing around 14-15 questions. You are not required to attempt all of these questions in a single sitting, in single day. You are free to attempt as many as question you can attempt. I'll be sharing around 15 to 20 questions. So you can basically attempt and try all of these questions at your ease. Whenever you find it comfortable to do so. All right. So in today's session, we were basically discussing the accounting equation, and we have covered the few special cases based on accounting, based on business transactions. All right. So this is it for today's session. We'll meet in the next class and cover a few other topics. So till then, take care. Goodbye, okay, everyone. Allah Hafiz.
Allah. Bye, sir. Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you, sir.